Welcome to Subramani. Today I'm going to answer some queries which I receive. And before that, let me just clarify. Don't expect me to do your financial planning. Don't expect me to do your asset allocation or choose funds for you. That is the job of a financial advisor who has to know you. I just know your name. Like I pick up a name that say Narendra Upadhyay. I have no clue who you are, what is your age, what you should be doing. So just a question of, I am investing in mutual fund since 2017 for my 6-year-old daughter. And I have investments in the following: HDFC Top 100, Sundaram Mid Cap, Aditya Birla Tax Relief, Franklin India Prima, HDFC Equity and Kotak Blue Chip. Now, the question is, I have more than 11 lakhs and the funds are running in red, whereas the market is reaching 40,000 Sensex. It's a little older, maybe now it's 41,000 Sensex, but to me it does not make any difference. Now the question is, how much you have, how much you need, what is your risk taking profile, what is your portfolio other than this, what is your age apart from your daughter's age, do you have adequate insurance, have you written your will? To me, those questions are perhaps far more important. I have nothing against to say against an HDFC Top 100 or Aditya Birla Tax Relief or Franklin India Prima, but all these funds will go through good phases and bad phases. Are these good funds? Yes, these are good funds. Are these good funds suitable for you? I really do not know whether it is suitable for you. What exactly do you want to ask is something very dangerous. Largely people trying to ask, is this okay to invest these funds? Now, even if I tell you it is okay to invest in these funds, I am telling you this in say November 2020. Maybe by June 2021, I may change my mind. Something may happen in these funds. What happens to your investments? So either you are a DIY, do it yourself investor, and you know these answers, or you need an advisor. This is halfway between, I mean, asking somebody whether these funds are okay makes no sense. Okay means what? Are these good fund houses? Yes. Do they have SEBI approval to do the business? Yes. Is this scheme good? Yes. But this scheme is good maybe for another 15 years. Maybe it is not good for the next 1 year. Maybe it is bad for another 2 years. 3 years later, it will be better. But I have invested in some of these funds and I've been there for last, say, 18, 20 years. To me, these have been good. They have given me good returns. But then I don't look at it on a daily basis. I don't worry about it. I just see, oh, it's a good fund manager and good fund house. After that, I don't bother on a day-to-day basis. Secondly, please understand the limitations of media. I'm not trying to tell you what media is saying is wrong, but media is meant for far more difficult questions, far more sophisticated questions, in the sense that you say, okay, I have done this kind of an asset allocation. What is wrong with this kind of an asset allocation, or what is right with this kind of an asset allocation? These are broader questions. You will not expect to see me here saying, oh, this fund house is bad or this scheme is bad, because this there are no bad schemes, there are no bad fund houses. All of them have been approved by SEBI, so they're all doing their business. Some of them are performing well, some may perform well after some time, some may have performed well in the past. So the question is, will you know how to get into the best scheme continuously in and out? I have no clue how people do that or how people even claim to do that. For example, nowadays it's fashionable to say this Axis Fund House is doing very well, or Parag Parikh Financial Services, PPFAS is doing very well. Well, I have some investment in Axis, I have some investment in PPFAS, but I have investment in Templeton, in Invesco, in DSP, in Franklin Templeton, in all fund houses, in various schemes. Some money would be there, but overall I'm an equities guy, so I'll have money in equities also. So the question is, it's very difficult for so-called experts to answer these questions. We do answer them regularly on media, but please understand the limitations of this. Now, if you take this schemes, he has got, it's a reasonably good scheme. He's got something in HDFC Equity Fund, which claims to be a multi-cap fund, but it has 70% in large cap. So if you go to Morningstar rating, you will find that this is classified as a large cap and not as a multi-cap. So you have Kotak Blue Chip, which is again large cap. You have HDFC Top 100, which is large cap. You have So three, four large cap schemes. Then he's got Prima, which is a mid cap scheme. He's got Sundaram mid cap, which is again a mid cap scheme. And Aditya Birla tax relief, right? So it is a reasonable portfolio, but doesn't make any sense to put 2,000 rupees in so many funds. You're much better off putting, consolidating from six funds. You can easily come down to two funds or three funds. One large cap, one mid cap, and one some tax relief which you have, which you obviously cannot sell off. The others, maybe you just cut down to two, three schemes. However, nowadays I'm finding advisors also asking clients to put in three large cap schemes, two, three mid cap schemes, two, three small cap schemes, plus an ELSS. That means 7-8 schemes to start with, plus 4-5 debt funds. So why do they do this? Because I think it's become very simple. All you need is a MFU account. So then you can sit and do all the investments in one place. The advantage for doing this from the IFA's point of view is to say, "Dekho sir, ye chal gaya, ye chal gaya," which means they don't want to take a bet. Also, because when the client goes to a party, he wants to talk about, "Oh, I've got in this fund, I've got in that fund." He also likes to have 7-8 funds. So whenever I see portfolios with 14 schemes and 15 schemes, I realize that, you know, something is obviously wrong with the advice. You stick to one large cap, one mid cap, one small cap, that's more than enough. But however, people like to say, "No, I want two, three large caps." So then three large caps, three mid cap. I think it's an overkill. Many people have 14 schemes and 15 schemes. This guy at least has only six. And of course, they can always argue, "See, it's doing well." Believe me, when you have in so many schemes, you are underperforming the index. So you might as well be in an index fund. What is wrong in just being in one index fund? One large cap index fund, one mid cap index fund is good enough for you, right? So don't try, I mean, I don't even know what you're trying to do. If you're trying to chase alpha by being in so many schemes, I can assure you, you're not getting the alpha, right? So understand, as a retail investor, you have to do only one thing. You have to make sure that you meet your goals. So it doesn't matter into how many funds, what you're putting, but I do think putting 2,000 rupees in six funds makes no sense. You're much better off putting 6,000 in two schemes. That is much better that way. Thank you. I'll take the next question. Next question is even worse, and he has said, "Don't give my name out." Okay, I'll not give your name out. So his age is 40 years, and current SIP along with the amount invested is attached here. I want to continue the SIP of 1 lakh for the next 15 years with 5% year-on-year increase. The goal is to use this corpus for kids' education, which is 10 years from now, and my own retirement planning, which is 18 years from now. Now look at, I need your answer for the following. Whether the fund selection is fine,